Baby, don't let me go, babe. Baby, don't say no, babe.
Hey, y'all, welcome to my channel. This is my first YouTube video, as y'all know. So, yeah, I'm basically gonna be trying to like recreate a look that I did around this time last year. But I'm not like a makeup professional or anything, so if it turns out bad, I'm sorry. Please don't use this as a tutorial. But yeah, we're gonna go ahead and get into the makeup, and I'll be answering y'all questions as I go. So okay, so first I'm following a makeup tutorial on YouTube as I do this, so I'm really multitasking for real. But the first thing I'm gonna use is this color right here. It's an orange. I don't really know what makeup brush to use though, so hold on. Okay, so the girl in the video is using a brush like it looks like this one, so I'm gonna use this one. Okay, so the first question is, why did I choose ECSU? So I chose ECSU because they have cheap tuition. Honestly, that was my only reason for wanting to go there at first. But I actually really like ECSU. Like, I didn't think I was gonna like it at first because it was a really small school in the middle of nowhere in a city that I hadn't even heard of. And when I was in the area for orientation, I noticed there wasn't like no whole bunch around there. Like, there's not a lot to do around there. But it's actually really fun. Like, even with there not being a lot in the area, we find a lot to do. Okay, so I think I gotta dip into the other palette for this one. Okay, so this is the Watch Me Blush palette, also from the crayon case. It's real cute, but she's not using the same like brand or anything as me. She's using something else. I don't know what she's using, but oh, she's using NYX. But I don't have NYX. I have the crayon case. So yeah, she used like a color close to the first one and just kind of went all on her eyelids. So I'm gonna do that with, I'm gonna use this one. So she went like here and here. Okay, so the next question is, how do you react to fake people? I try not to surround myself with fake people, but usually if I have to surround myself with somebody that's fake, like I used to cheer and I'm on a dance team now, and so there's always going to be like somebody that's fake in the group. There's always going to be somebody that's talking about you, somebody that has negative things to say, but you know, smiling all in your face. It happens everywhere you go, honestly. Like, there's no way to avoid it. There's always that one person. So for me, I'm not really the type of person to cause a whole scene or anything like that. But if it's somebody that I have to speak to on a daily basis, say like a teammate or something, I just keep it short. So like, if they ask me a question, answer the question, yes, no, that's it. You're not gonna get much out of me. Like, if you try and say a joke to me, I'm probably just gonna look at you like, I don't entertain the foolishness. Like, if I really know that you're talking about me behind my back, what reason do I have to sit here and be fake to you, you know? Like, I'm not you. You talking about me behind my back and you smiling in my face, I don't have time for it. Okay, so next, she used like a dark purple. So I'm gonna go in with this dark color right here. It's kind of like a mix between dark blue and dark purple. So I'm gonna use this, but yeah. So the next question is, how do you start making lip gloss? I started making lip gloss because a lot of like videos of people mixing lip glosses and like selling their own homemade lip glosses would pop up. And I would just look and I'm like, dang, I really want to do that. I want to try to do that, you know, because I use a lot of lip gloss. I love lip gloss. I'm like a lip gloss junkie almost. That got in my eye. So I was already making products. So at a certain point, after watching a bunch of other people making like lip gloss videos and stuff like that, it made me want to start my own. So, you know, I told my mom, I was like, I kind of want to add lip gloss to my product line. And she was just like, yeah, that would be cool. When I was on campus one day, I had a little money. You know, my mom had sent me like $100. And I was like, might as well go ahead and spend this money to, you know, put some more products into my business. So I ordered a bunch of stuff to make. I ordered a bunch of stuff to make the products. So I ordered like the lip gloss base, all the oils. I ordered some glitters and stuff like that. Yeah, I started because of videos that were on my Instagram feed. Starting to look like a five-year-old playing in makeup, but it's fine. The girl in the video used like a, I think it's called a primer or something like that. Like the little cream stuff that you put on your eye before you start the makeup so it can make the colors pop. And I don't have that, so whatever. So I'm gonna go in with this color right here. It's called Outsider. So I'm gonna go in with that. So the next question, also another business related question, is what made you start selling your products and why those certain products? What made me start selling my products was that I think my sophomore year in high school, when I was at Trout with Madison High School, we had to do this little science fair. Like, it was required for part of your science grade. And so like 2 weeks before, I realized that I hadn't even started. I didn't have any idea what I was gonna do, anything like that. And I was scrolling on YouTube, watching these videos about how to like grow your hair quickly or whatever. And I believe that was right after I had just cut my hair too. Like, I cut it kind of short, like here maybe. And so I was looking at videos, how to grow your hair, and I came across this thing called the inversion method. And basically it's when you like put oil on your scalp every night and then you get on a bed or on a like edge of something and you kind of just hang over it with your head like this, like hanging off the edge of the bed. And it's supposed to like make the blood cells or something like that in your head. I don't know. It's just basically just supposed to help your hair grow a lot quicker. So I used that as my science project, and I didn't want to use just like one oil. So I went to the store, got all these different types of oils. So I mixed all of that together, made my little oil or whatever, and then I was just rubbing it on my scalp like every night, every other night for like those 2 or 3 weeks. And my hair actually grew. So it grew from like, let's say if it was here, it grew like here. Here. Yeah. So after then, I was like, oh, okay, that's cool, you know, whatever, whatever. That's kind of really just what started it. Like, after making a growth oil, I was like, I wonder what else I can make. Okay, so the next thing she did was go in with eyelashes, but this does not look the way that hers do. So I'm about to try and fix it up before I go and put some eyelashes on. So the next question is, who is my crush? I don't have a crush on anybody right now. I'm kind of like just chilling on by myself, you know, because yeah. Okay, so next is, have I ever fell in love? I feel like no, I haven't. Like, I've been in relationships and stuff where did I love the people? Yes, of course. But I don't feel like I was necessarily in love. I don't know. I feel like I'll know when I'm actually in love with somebody versus just I love them or I have love for them. It's hard doing makeup when you have really small eyes because you have really small eyelids. So I'm really trying my best here and I feel like I am failing. Because look what I've completely ruin this look. But the next question is, what is my favorite food? My favorite food is either gonna be crab or salmon. Like, I really like seafood. Like, a lot. Like, I'd probably be a pescatarian if I could stay away from chicken. I can't stay away from chicken for some reason. Like, I can, but I can't. Like, I can, but I can't. Get some butter, put a little, what's it called? Obey seasoning in the butter. Mix it up, warm it up, you know. Dip the crab in. Okay, I'm about to go back in with the teal color on my, I think it's called the inner lid. I think that's what they call it, right here. But the next question is, how was college? So from my college experience so far, it's actually pretty fun. Like, everybody might not be able to say the same, but college is what you make it. So, like, yeah, you really gotta, you basically decide your college experience. So that's just that on that. I don't really know what else to say about that. But yeah, college for me so far has been fun for the most part. The only part that isn't fun is for me taking tests, because I get bad test anxiety. Like, I'll literally cry over taking a test. But yeah, to shorten it up, college, it's been fun for me, but it's been stressful just because I don't know how to, like, deal with taking tests and doing stuff like that. And I just get stressed out really easily when there's a lot of work to do or when I do have to take a test. So yeah, just, I don't know, make sure you figure out how you're going to handle things personally, like how you're going to relieve your own stress before you come, and how you're going to study for things, how you're going to make sure you're keeping up with all your work and everything like that. So the next thing I'm going to do is take all the colors that I use, like, in the sections, and I'm going to go under my eyes, like, to my waterline, and basically put those colors down here just to give it, like, a real, you know, pop kind of thing. So, I mean, I should have been using this brush. This is turning out, okay, don't pay attention to this necessarily, but this is turning out a lot better with me using this little bitty brush right here. I should have used this from the beginning. But yeah. Okay, so the next question is, how do you make college more fun? So I guess they're trying to say, like, how do you have a fun experience in college? So I would say, like, for me, I joined a team. So on the dance team, shout out to Royal Blaze. Yeah, I would say join a team, join a club, or, like, got makeup everywhere. Join a team, join a club, or, like, find a group that suits you. And, like, get out, go to the events that they have, because colleges actually have so many fun events. Now, with me being on a team, or with you, like, joining a team, you will have commitments that you have to make where you'll have to, like, miss some or a lot of the events. Like, there's a lot of events that I wish I could have gone to this year, but I couldn't because I was at practice, or we had somewhere to be, like, we had an event somewhere or something like that. So yeah, just be warned that with you joining the team, you are making a commitment, a time commitment for real. But yeah, you'll make a lot of friends with you being on a team though, because you're gonna have to be around those people all the time. Like, being in band, that dang near becomes, like, that is your friend group, that's your family, like, whatever group you're with. If you're a dancer, if you're an instrument player, those are the people that you're gonna be around all the time. Like, and you automatically have friends. So at this point, there's literally, like, there's makeup everywhere. At this point, it's pretty obvious that this look is not turning out how I wanted it to, but lashes fix everything. So we're going to use, I already took the lashes out the box, but the crayon case, their little lash pack, it comes with, like, 3 sets of lashes in here. So I don't know which one I'm about to use. Okay, so I'm gonna take this little green makeup stick thing that I have, like, put it on all the little, I don't have that many, but, like, the dark marks and stuff that's on my face, or, like, pimples and stuff, I'm gonna put it on that. Okay, so I'm gonna go ahead and wipe off all the like extra eyeshadow that fell everywhere else. Okay, so the question was, have I ever cried at a movie? So the answer is a yes. I don't know how many of y'all have seen the movie before, but there's this movie, My Sister's Keeper. That movie gets me every single time. That gets me every time. Makes me cry for real. I don't have any like makeup brushes or sponges with me, and none of them came in this kit because it's more of like an eye shadow thing, not like a foundation and stuff like that. So what I do have is this Maybelline Fit Me Matte and Poreless Liquid Foundation. Yeah, it's pretty close to my skin tone. And since I don't have any brushes, I kind of just put it on my fingertips, and we're gonna make something out of nothing. Okay, so the next question was, do you have a nickname? And if so, what is it? So yes, I do have a nickname, and my nickname is Cauliflower. And yes, cauliflower, like the vegetable, but not like the vegetable. Like, I really cannot figure out, like, oh, it's a sticker on here. That's why it wouldn't come out. Okay. Y'all gotta excuse me. I'm a little slow sometimes. Okay, so next, I'm gonna put on a little bit of eyeliner. Okay, so I'm about to use, I know I showed y'all the lashes already, but I'm gonna use these ones down here. And the next question is, short hair or long hair? For me, I feel like long hair looks best on me just because I like to wear my hair in an afro a lot. And my hair, when it's like long, once it's like grown out and stuff like that, big afros look really good on me. Short hair does look good on certain people. I just feel like for me, it doesn't. And it's probably because my head is so big that it does not look good. That's just a personal opinion. That's on me, you know. So I had some technical difficulties with my phone. So here we are a couple hours later. But anyways, this is the finished look. And I hope y'all like this video. If you did like it, make sure to comment, like, and subscribe. Share this video to your friends. And I'll see y'all next time. If you don't let me go, babe, baby, don't.